We will go for vitamin B7. Which is also called as biotin or beta biotin, sometimes also called as vitamin H. Also, it has a previously it was known as anti egg white injury factor. These are the names for vitamin B7. There are lots of names: biotin, beta biotin, vitamin H, or anti-egg white injury factor. These are the names for this vitamin B7. It is sparingly soluble in water as well as in fats. So it has a low solubility in both water as well as fats, but it is containing sulfur and it is a B complex vitamin. It participates in carboxylation reactions. It participates in carboxylation reactions. We had seen it previously that decarboxylation is carried out by using vitamin B1 as well as vitamin B6. B1 and B6 undergoes or catalyzes affects the decarboxylation steps, but vitamin B7 will be useful for carboxylation steps, addition of a carboxyl group in the molecule. The structure for vitamin B6, B7 is very simple. Having two five-membered rings fused together. One of the rings contains two nitrogens and the other ring contains sulfur. This side we will have a side chain of four carbon atoms and terminal as a carboxylate group. So overall the structure of vitamin B6, B7 is this, which is having fused two five-membered rings where we have this ring as a thiophene ring, a reduced thiophene ring, and this ring is a imidazole ring as it contains two nitrogens. So it is an imidazole ring. This is the point of attachment or site of CO2 binding. The carboxylate group that is needs to be donated binds over this nitrogen. This side chain where the carboxylate group is present, this carboxylate group binds to lysine NH2 of enzyme, so that it will be in a bound form with the enzyme, and when it is bound form containing carboxylate group, we call it as a biotin carboxylate carrier protein. We call it as a BCCP, which is, means biotin carboxylate carrier protein. Sources for this vitamin B5. There are lots of sources are there for vitamin B5, and it is widely distributed both among the plants as well as animals. So deficiency of vitamin B7 rarely occurs, but the major sources of this is are milk, tomatoes, grains and eggs are the major sources for vitamin B7 or biotin. The deficiency of this vitamin B7 occurs rarely. But when it occurs, it will be including the anemia, loss of appetite, nausea, dermatitis, that is skin disease, glossitis. We have seen this glossitis in vitamin B2 also, that is smoothness of the tongue or purplish tongue. It may also result in depression, hallucinations, that is abhasona, kisi cheez ka jo nahi hota hai uska bhi abhasona, that we call it as a hallucinations. Then muscle pain. These are the symptoms of deficiency of vitamin B7. Generally, vitamin B7 deficiency is rare as it is widely distributed in food chain, both in the animals as well as in plants. And also it is supplied by intestinal bacteria. So deficiency is rare, but when it may occur due to destruction of intestinal bacteria by prolonged use of sulfur containing drugs, या फिर एंटीबायोटिक्स अगर आप ले रहे हो ज्यादा समय के लिए, या फिर सल्फर कंटेनिंग ड्रग्स लाइक सल्फोनामाइड्स अगर आप ज्यादा ले रहे हो, ज्यादा दिनों तक ले रहे हो, तो फिर आपका जो इंटेस्टाइन में बैक्टीरिया है वो उनका पॉपुलेशन कम हो जाता है, एंड दैट मे रिजल्ट इनटू डेफिशिएंसी ऑफ विटामिन बी सेवन. एंड दैट इज वाई वेन एवर यू आर टेकिंग एंटीबायोटिक्स और सल्फोनामाइड ड्रग्स, डॉक्टर्स जनरली रिकमेंड बी कॉम्प्लेक्स सप्लीमेंट्स, because it need to maintain adequate amount of vitamins due to destruction of bacteria in the intestine. There will be inadequacy of the vitamins. The second main cause for deficiency of vitamin B6 is consumption of raw eggs. Raw eggs generally contains a glycoprotein called as avidin. This avidin binds with vitamin B7 very tightly. It binds to vitamin B7 very tightly and blocks the vitamin B7. And because it is blocking vitamin B7, it will not no longer be available to carry out the reactions. And hence, there will be artificial deficiency of vitamin B7 is occurring when we are consuming large amount of raw eggs. Generally, gym mein agar aap apna body banane ke liye jaate ho, to vitamin raw eggs aap generally zyada consume karte ho. और एज ए सोर्स ऑफ प्रोटीन्स, लेकिन जब ये रॉ एग्स ज्यादा लेते हो तो वहां पर बी सेवन का डेफिशियंसी क्रिएट हो जाता है. जनरली इट रिक्वायर्स 20 रॉ एग्स कंजम्पशन टू क्रिएट डेफिशियंसी ऑफ विटामिन बी सेवन. दिस वॉज फॉर डेफिशियंसी ऑफ विटामिन बी सेवन. बायोकेमिकल फंक्शन ऑफ विटामिन बी सेवन आर majorly there are three biochemical functions are present for vitamin B7. One is a gluconeogenesis, and in TCA cycle. Yahan pe we have a pyruvic acid or pyruvate. This pyruvate upon carboxylation by using vitamin B7, it undergoes carboxylation reaction to form oxaloacetate. So oxaloacetate is a very important ingredient of TCA cycle or tricarboxylic acid cycle. It can be synthesized from pyruvic acid by using carboxylation using vitamin B7. Then in the second, in fatty acid synthesis, where the acetyl-CoA undergoes carboxylation reaction in presence of vitamin B7, to form malonyl-CoA as the first step for fatty acid synthesis. Our lecture will get over in few seconds. The last is metabolism of leucine. It participates in metabolism of leucine. So these are the for about the vitamin B7.